Hey everybody, we've had a request for how to just animate a simple stick figure, which is very basic. I'm not going to get very deeply into rigging, but this is the way I teach even young kids to animate. The fact is, I can't think of another program where you can have a character moving around as quickly as this. So let's get to it. File, new. I'm in Moho, but it doesn't matter. There's nothing I'm going to do that won't work with any version of Anime Studio ever made, as far as I know. So, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to rename my layer 1 to body. It's a really good idea to name your layers. You don't need to, but when you're glancing over at your layer panel with a ton of stuff in it, you're going to wish you would name things. So, I'm going to draw a body. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my shapes tool. I'm going to get my rectangle tool. I've set my fill and stroke to black because I'm just going to go with that black stick figure look. So let me draw a chest. Let me draw a leg. Let me draw another leg about the same. Let me draw an arm. Let me draw another arm about the same. Switch to the circle. Draw a circle. There. There's our character. So what do I do next? I come over here. I'm going to create a bone layer for the bones that are going to control him. Oop. New bone. I'll name that Stickman. And right now, if I put bones in, they won't control the body because the body is not inside the bone layer. It needs to be in the bone layer. So I'm just going to click on body. I'm going to drag it over top of the stick man. You can see it kind of outlines when I do that. Drop it, and you notice that the body layer just indented. It's in there. You can also test by clicking the little triangle next to the bone. When it closes, the children in it are hidden, and that's great. If you've got a ton of stuff going on, you can hide your group, hide and show the things in your group that you don't need to be seeing right now. I'll leave that open. So let's do it. Let's put in a skeleton. And this is going to be a very simple skeleton. So, first thing I'm going to do, click and drag to make a spine. I'm not going to give him more than one spine bone. Very basic. The bone is selected. You can tell because it's bright red. And when a bone is selected and another bone is drawn, that is that new bone becomes a child of the bone that was selected when you started drawing it. So I'll draw that. There we go. There's a head bone. Now, if I drew another bone for the arm, say right now, that arm would be parented to the head bone. And the body doesn't work that way. Everything comes off the spine. The head comes off the spine, each arm comes off the spine, and each leg comes off the spine. We'll talk about parenting in a bit. But what I'm going to do, get my select bone tool, select the spine again. I'm going to draw a bone about halfway down. And then the lower arm bone is going to be a child of the upper arm bone. So I'll just click and finish it. Switch back, select the spine again. Repeat. Halfway, half the rest of the way. Spine. Now, I've seen a tutorial on rigging a stick man on YouTube, and it's absolutely terrible. It gets a lot of things wrong. And here's one of the things it gets wrong completely. I'm going to add new bones for the legs. People seem to do this all the time. They start drawing at the foot. That's not how a leg works. The hip connects to the spine. So make sure that I just undid to get rid of those bones. So I'm going to click to make sure that spine is selected. It's red. I knew it was. Halfway down, switch, click. Now I know this next hip's going to be connected to the spine because it's red. Halfway down, rest of the way down. That's my whole skeleton, all done. Get my manipulate bone tool and start turning things around. And you'll notice that these bones are grabbing onto things they shouldn't. And we'll talk about that in a minute. You'll also notice some other things like the arm isn't bending. And we'll also talk about that. So when I'm using the manipulate bone tool in frame 0, it's just for practice. It's just for testing. When I go back to select bone tool, everything pops back automatically. All right, so let's look at the different problems. First of all, let me talk about parenting. When you click the parent bone tool, it's a big bone with a line leading to a smaller bone. It'll show you how all the bones connect up. So you see all these bones form a line that eventually reaches the spine. That's what you want. Now, if you had made a mistake, let me say, you had accidentally parented that bone to the head, and let's also say you had also messed up big time and parented that bone to the leg, which I've seen way too many times. Now when I move that leg, wow, that's all over the place. The head's moving that arm, what a mess. To reparent, when you check your parenting and you see things are pointing wrong, to fix them, get your select bone tool, select the bone that was parented wrong, go back to your parent bone tool, and now just click on the bone that you actually want to be parented to. So I'll click to the spine, and you notice it's now pointing to the spine. That's what you want. I'll also select this bone, get my parent bone tool, and I'm going to click on the upper arm. Okay, so now all my arrows are nice and neat and into the spine. So that's perfect. So how do we fix the bones controlling spots that they shouldn't? Well, I'll go to my bone strength tool. It's the bone with the kind of capsule shape around it. And those shaded areas you're seeing are the bone strength. They're the where the bone can influence. And you'll see on the legs especially, they overlap so much. And that's why the legs are grabbing onto one another. So we'll just shrink that bone strength to what we actually need. All you do is with the bone strength tool, you click on a bone. Notice the bone turns red because it's selected, and also the shading turns red because it's the shading area of the selected bone. And I'm just going to click and drag to the left, and that'll make it smaller. To the right makes it bigger, but now that's going to cause major trouble because it controls the whole body. So bring it in, and I'm just going to make it big enough to contain the upper part of the leg. Ditto with the lower part, and I'm just going to do both legs to show you. Go back to my manipulate bones tool. Now notice the leg dragging isn't anywhere as bad. So let me go ahead, body, just bring it in a bit. Head, I'll probably leave just about where it is. Do the arms the way I did, just bring them in. Don't worry that there's some overlap, but don't worry about it, or don't have everything overlapping as heavily as it would by default. Okay, so let's take a look. See, things are moving a lot better. The arms aren't grabbing onto the head. The legs aren't grabbing onto one another. If I move an arm down all the way here, it's not grabbing too much onto the body. But you'll notice another problem we've got here. When I bend the arms, they don't bend at the elbow, and the knees don't bend, or the legs don't bend at the knee. Okay, why is that? That's because I need to go to my body shape and explain something about how vectors work. This is just made up of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shapes, 5 rectangles, and 1 circle for the head. And the head's selected right now, so you can see that the head is made up of 4 points with lines between them. You can see the 4 points, they're red because they're selected. Let me choose an arm instead and zoom in. Now, when I come back up here, when I go and manipulate that arm, you'll notice it's not bending at the elbow. So let's take a look again at that arm. The reason it isn't is because the lines between the points don't bend. They can be rounded or they can be straight, but they won't bend with a bone. You need more points. You need a point above and below the elbow so that it has something to work with. So I'm going to get my add point tool and move it onto this upper line right above where the elbows meet. And you'll notice, I hope, that when I come over top, you get a little red circle under the tool. That shows you're right over, and if you click, you're going to add the point to that, you're going to add that point to that line. Click. If I just clicked out here, there's a point just hanging out all by itself that does nothing. So I'll delete that. And you can check, you can get your translate or move point tool and see how that, yeah, that's definitely connected. Let me undo, and I'll come over here, and there's the red circle, so I'll click. And now I'll go back to my bone layer, and I'll get my thing, and ta-da! Now the arm bends. So let's just come over here, and real quickly, add point tool, move over. There's my little red circle showing that it's going to add the point to that line. There's my little red circle, point to that line. Same for the knees. Pop, 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 pop. And let's zoom out. Come in a little bit. There's my character. Go back to the bone layer and let's test him. You know, the head has a little bit of control over the shoulders, but it's nowhere as bad as it was. The arms move, the arms bend, the legs move, the legs bend. And now you have a fully animatable stick figure. Nothing beautiful, nothing impressive, but it's a great way to practice rigging. Just the very basic. And I recommend for further that you go onto McCoy Buck's Udemy courses and take his one on character rigging, because it allows you to see how to take this very basic method and turn it into some pretty wonderful characters. So thanks for sticking with me through all this, and I hope that helps.